وتعالى أنهم يحبون الله تبارك وتعالى. فأنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى رب العالمين هذه الآية اختبارا وابتلاء وامتحانا. So in that sense, Allah تبارك وتعالى sent this verse down as a test, as a examination, and as putting them into a test. هذه الآية, and this verse, here it is, the mizan, it is that measurement stick, الذي يعرف به من أحب الله حق يعني حقيقة. And it is that the mizan, meaning the measurement stick, to know whereby a person truly love Allah in reality. Whether in reality or not, the person loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore he say, وَمَنْ دَعَى ذَلِكَ. So whomsoever is claiming that, right? And he is only having a claim, مُجَرَّدَةً. It is just a mere claim. Right? The claim that is not followed with this test, then it is just, barakallahu fikum, a claim. It is nothing else but a claim. So he mentioned, فَعَلَامَةُ مَحَبَّةِ اللَّهِ اتِّبَاعَ رَسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّهُ مُتَابَعَتُهُ وَجَمِيعِ مَا يَدُعُو إِلَيْهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى مَحَبَّتِهِ وَرِضْوَانِهِ سبحانه وتعالى. فلا ينال محبة الله ورضوانه وثوابه إلا بتصديق ما جاء به الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من الكتاب والسنة وامتثال أوامرهما واجتناب نهيهما. فمن فعل ذلك أحب الله وجزاه جزاء المحبين وغفر له ذنوبه وستر عليه عيوبه. As we clarified this also, this issue last week, that this verse, or the alama, the sign of that one love Allah, is that he followed the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah has made the follow of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a test for those who are claiming that they love him. And likewise, Allah Jalla wa'ala has made the following of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and every single thing to be, meaning to be the path, the tariq, that will lead the person to the love of Allah and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one is not able to achieve the love of Allah and the pleasure of Allah and the reward except by way of holding it to be the truth, whatever the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, from the book and from the sunnah, by way of carrying out the commands that came from the book and from the sunnah, and by abstaining from both, yani prohibition that came from the sunnah, from the Quran and the sunnah. فَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلِكَ, whoever has done such, أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ, Allah will love him in return, and he will reward him with the reward of those that he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves them, and he is pleased with them. وَغَفَرَ لَهُ ذُنُوبَهُ, and he will forgive them of their sins. And not only that, but he, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, will shield, and he will hide, and he will, barakallahu fikum, hide their sins. He will cover for them. So he mentioned, hafidhahullah. وَكَأَنَّهُ قِيلَ, it is all as if it is said. وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ, with all of this, what is the real following of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? وَمَا صِفَتُهَا, and what is the characteristic of following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? فَأَجَابَ بِقَوْلِهِ, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he responded by saying this, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ, Obey Allah, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ, obey Allah وَالرَّسُولَ, and obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he meaning, بِإِمْتِثَالِ الْأَمْرِ, by way of carrying out the command, وَجْتِنَابِ النَّهِي, and to stay away from the prohibition, وَتَصْدِيقُ al-khabar and to hold that every information, every yani, report that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given us, it is the truth. That everything that he has given is the truth. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا عَنْ ذَٰلِكَ فَهُوَ كُفْرٌ. And whoever turn away from that, it is disbelief. Whoever turn away from that, it is disbelief. Turning away from what is disbelief? Turning away from what is disbelief? Khalilu? No, what I just say right here. Don't give me an answer that is a broad answer. Turning away from what is disbelief? You listening? No, you're not. I'm going to repeat it again. So it was as if he would be asked, how do we obey the messenger? How do we follow the messenger? Allah, he replied by saying, قُلْ أَتِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولُ. Obey Allah and his messenger. Meaning. Carrying out his commands. Staying away from his prohibitions. And holding to be the truth whatever he informs us of. This is how one is to be following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How one is to be following the Prophet. And then? I just repeated it. I just, be quiet. Very good, carrying out his command. Okay, what else? Didn't say that. Carrying out his command. Stay away from the prohibition. Carrying the command, that's what he say. He already say that? Somebody bell him, Hassan. Rahim, no mention that. We mention that. They are, no, tasdiquhu. Yes. To hold that everything that the Prophet told us is the truth. If I ask you again, you don't know me, that would be a really problem. Right? He say, يعني بإمتثال أوامره. How do you follow the Prophet? By way of carrying out his command. Staying away from his prohibitions. And holding that everything that he, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, told us is the truth. You got it? He say now, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا عَنْ ذَٰلِكَ. Whoever, if the person turns away from this, then فَهُوَ كُفْرٌ and فَهُوَ الْكُفْرُ. And this is disbelief. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any doubt, does not love the disbelievers. Allah does not love the disbelievers. Wa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam huwa Rasulullah ila jami'i thaqalayni. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Prophet of all of the thaqalayni. And when the term thaqalayni is being mentioned, it is both the jinn and the mankind. Whenever you hear the word thaqalayni, it means the jinn and the mankind. So he, the Prophet alayhi salatu was sent to all of the mankind and the jinn kind. No one is exempt from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a message. Meaning he was not only sent to the Arabs. He was not only sent to the whites. But rather he was sent to every single one. To the Quraysh aydan. He was sent to everybody. Every single nation Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala sent the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to them. Whether whites, blacks, Chinese, Mexicans, you name it. All of the nations, barakallahu fikum. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam to everybody. Tayyip. He say, walau kana al-anbiya'u, even the prophets themselves. He say, even the mursaloon, those who are the messengers, right? The prophets, the messengers. And likewise, ulul azmi, bal al-ulul azm minhum, even those who are the ulul azm, meaning who? Meaning the five strong determination prophets. And you have from those, barakallahu fikum, the ulul azm min al-rusul. You have prophet before him, Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. And you have Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. And then Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. And then Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. And then you have the prophet Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam. Right? So even the ulul azm, right? Even the ulul azm, if they were to be alive after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent, that they will follow him. They will follow him. They will not have none to do. They will not bring about a new legislation. All of that, what they will be doing is, except that they will follow him, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, illa an yadkhulu fi ta'atihi, except that they will enter in following the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning, if Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was to be alive after that the Prophet Muhammad was sent, Ibrahim will follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was to be alive after the Prophet was sent, then Musa alayhi salatu wasalam will follow the Messenger Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wasalam. So no one is exempt. Shuf, no one is exempt to be following the Messenger sallallahu. If Ibrahim is not exempt to follow the Prophet Muhammad, then who is exempt to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? If Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is not to be bringing nothing new, right? Then who are the Tijanis to be bringing something new? If Ibrahim, if he was to be alive, he will not bring nothing new. All he will do is simply follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So who are the murid to be bringing something new? Who are the other groups to be bringing something new? If they were alive, these messengers, not even the messenger, bal ulul azm minhum, the strong will determination prophets, if they were alive, lama wasi'ahum illa ittiba'uhu. And all they would have do is what? Follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So therefore that means what? That if the prophets, the messengers, ulul azm, they don't have no other choice but to follow the Prophet, they don't gonna bring nothing new. Then who are us? Who are we, barakallahu fikum? Who are we to be wanna bringing about new matters in the religion? Of course, then what is for us is only to follow the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. فَلَا بُدَّ مِنْ مَحَبَّةِ الرَّسُولِ. It is a must to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this love, it is not a lip service. Just like when this individual...
Move back a little bit.
It's like this individual, barakallahu fikum, for them, this is how they show their love for the Prophet. When the Prophet, his name is mentioned, they don't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know how they do? They will be clacking their fingers. Like this. Come sit right here. Come sit right here. And this is how when the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a name is being mentioned, instead of saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they don't do that. What they do is they will raise their hands and do like this, clack their fingers. Huh? What group? The Sufis do that. The Tijani Sufis, they do that. I mean, in general, the Sufis, when the Prophet name is mentioned, drink with your right hand. That they will be clacking their fingers like this. For them, this is showing the love of the Prophet. Or if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam name is mentioned, that you gotta get up and give some money. That's how you show in the Prophet